So now I can run my app, but it's probably not going to work because I haven't set up the API key. The next thing that you should do is to go to the Google console, and then based on the name of the app, like in this case, you can see my app is at com.google.devplat.elmaroney.maps at 3_2. I need to set that up within the API console. So if you remember in the earlier lesson when we created public API access, we had an API key and we had Android applications that were allowed to use that API key. And these were defined by the SHA1, in this case the debug one, followed by a semicolon, followed by the name of the application. Now you can see here I've done the same thing, the same SHA1, and now this application, com.google.devplat.elmaroney.maps32. This is the most common place you go wrong in writing applications and creating them, is that either you've named this incorrectly, you've made a mistake with the SHA1 key, your API key is wrong, or something along those lines. So if you see this API key beginning with ALZA and ending with DRZ8, if I go back to Android Studio and go to my Android manifest, you can see I have, it was AIZA, sorry, not ALZA. You can see I have the API key set up here correctly. And it's definitely the same name application, com.google.devplat.elmaroney.maps32. A little pro tip is if you ever refactor it, and you'll think you've refactored and you've gotten everything changed, if you refactor the name of your package, and you'll find that maps don't actually work, what can happen is that while you refactor it and while you've changed it on the console, in refactoring in build.gradle, the application ID string here may not change. So if you ever refactor your app and you find trouble, just make sure to come back into your build.gradle and make sure that the string here with an application ID matches the refactoring that you've done. So let's now run the application and take a look. And here it is again. Here's the application running. You can see I'm centered on New York City. I have my three buttons laid out across the top. Remember, that was the horizontal layout. And then the entire thing is in a vertical layout with the button panel on top of the actual map fragment. And of course, I can continue to pan and zoom around the map if I so desire. And when I press the buttons, for example, the hybrid button, I now get a hybrid map, which you'll see more closely if I zoom in. So you can see the street names were highlighted and the streets themselves were highlighted. So I have the satellite photographic map, but with the lines of roads and things laid out on top of it, which is really, really useful when you're navigating around places. Or if I just want the pure satellite picture, here it is. So it was as simple as that, very little coding, and you're beginning to see that you can build some pretty powerful functionality.